Okay, good morning all. So we'll continue with the paging system, right? And then we are going to cover segmentation. Okay, and if we'll get time, we will start with the part of virtual memory, right? But before that, we need to look at some examples, because in exams like GATE, the paging related questions are very frequently asked, right? So you should know how to solve them. Again, they are very simple. So we'll see them in brief, right? Okay, so can you see these slides? Is it visible to you? Okay, fine. So in case of paging, let us just revise the concept, right? We divide the process into number of pages, right? That is the first thing. And we divide the memory into number of frames. Now, what is the equation between size of pages and size of frame? Size of page and size of frame is equal, right? And how do we maintain the track of, let us say, allocation, current allocation? What is the data structure that is used for that? Page table is used to keep track of pages of a certain process. But how do you keep track of the current allocation? Which data structure we use for that? Free page list or free frame list, right? Frame list, actually, right? So from that you can find out how many frames are currently free, right? This one, is that fine, right? So looking at the current status of free frame list, what you can find out, how many frames are currently allocated, okay, and how many of them are free. Now, how to find out which are allocated? Using page table, as Rishi has said, right? How to find out which are allocated? Using the page table. Okay, now what is the restriction that was available in previous scenario when we studied the fixed partitioning and dynamic partitioning, which is not present over here in case of paging? Which restriction is lifted, in other words, when we are using paging? Yes, it is not required to load your pages in contiguous memory locations, right? Now, if you don't have a page table, let me ask another question on the same line. If you don't have a page table, can we go for non-contiguous allocation? No. Right? So I'm just trying to clear out the concepts, right? This kind of basic questions can be asked, right? And if you are not clear with the base, you will not be able to solve the examples. Okay, so that is very important. Fine. So are you all clear with the basics at least, right? How paging system works. Now we'll look at the remaining theory, and then I'll go with the examples. Okay, so before we go for that, let us refresh the types of addresses. There are three types of addresses we have in theory. One is physical address. Physical address is the actual location in the hardware. Okay, but ideally the program is maintaining which kind of addresses? Either logical or relative. Right, there are two options. Either you go with a logical addressing scheme or you go with a relative addressing scheme. Logical address is such an address which is not actually existing. But who generates that? That is one more question. Who generates that? It is CPU, exactly. Right? It is a task of CPU, right? OS will ask CPU to generate the address whenever a process is executing, or you can say whenever a process is created. Ideally, right? At creation time, this address will be generated. Okay, so that is the first point. Now, what is the relative address? Difference between logical and relative address is what? In case of relative address, what we know additionally, which is not known to us in case of logical address? You know the starting address, right? So you just have to perform a simple addition, right? Base address is the beginning physical address, right? That beginning physical address has to be added with relative address. What will be the answer? Actual physical address. Actual physical address, right? We are adding a relative address with a physical address. That is going to give us the physical address. Okay. So if you want to read any particular byte, let us now directly go straight into paging. If I want to read certain entry in the page, right? So how the address should be divided, right? So the address is divided in two parts. Okay. first part of my address is going to be page number, because if you think this as a book, book always has an index, right? From that index, we try to find out the page, okay? And from that page, we try to find out a certain line, isn't it? Are you following the analogy over here? First, we look at the page number, right? Then we go inside the page, okay, to find out a certain line. Same thing we have to do over here, okay? So the first part of your logical address, right? Or if you are using relative addressing scheme, then it can be relative address, right? So either logical or relative, the concept remains similar, okay? First part is going to be the page number. So which page contains my data? Okay, that is the first thing I should know. And then what will be offset in this situation? Yes, inside that page, where your actual information is located. Inside that page, right? Or you can say line number, that's correct, right? So the address is a combination of two things, page number and offset. Are you clear with this? Up to this, right? Page number and offset are the two things that make up your logical address. Now, page size is equal to frame size. Okay, so can I say that I can map the page number to the frame number? Is it possible, that mapping? Although the numbers will be different, right? Your page number one will be lying in frame number five. It is possible, right? But as the size is same, I can have a direct mapping. As well as, what about offset? Can I directly map the offset? Let us say in page number one, I was looking for fifth line. Okay. So can I say that in frame number five again, am I looking at the fifth line once again? Yes, right? Why so? What is the reason for that? Yes, I think Urjit is not clear. I'll repeat once again. See, size of the page and size of the frame are same, right? So if you are looking at byte number five or line number five in your page, right, it is same as looking at byte number five or line number five in the frame, right? Although frame number is different. Are you fine with this, Urjit? Right? Yes. Okay. So this is called address translation. This is the important part, right? We have to convert the logical address into physical address. The physical address is in which format? Frame number offset. Logical address is in which format? Page number offset. I have to convert page number offset format to frame number offset, right? This is done by a combination of your OS as well as the CPU hardware, right? You can see that over here. Actual mapping is done by CPU hardware because it is the CPU who knows the addresses, right? Who will control this entire scenario? OS, or you can say which part of your OS? Memory management unit, MMU. That's what we call it, right? Okay, so this is the basic slide. Based on that, further slides will be covered. Let us now cover the difference before we go into the advantage. Paging versus fixed partitioning. This kind of small difference can be asked, right? So you should know this. As we know, paging has a small partition size, right? As compared to fixed partitioning, obviously, right? Because what was the problem with fixed partitioning? We were having some amount of internal fragmentation, right? Now, what about paging? Do we still have internal fragmentation? Yes, the answer is yes. But internal fragmentation will not be, yes, I'll do that, Sainish. Internal fragmentation will not be in the previous pages. It will only be present where? In the last page. In the last page, right? So this is further advantage. Right, we are reducing the amount of internal fragmentation. Suppose all of your pages are of 1 KB, right? So it is possible that your last page might have some bytes of internal fragmentation. It will not be too much, right? So we can still ignore that, okay? Fine. Then paging does not require contiguous partition allocations, right? Paging does not require contiguous partition allocation, while in case of fixed partitioning, it is contiguous, right? Otherwise, you will not be able to read your information. Are you clear with these two differences? First difference is partition size. Second difference, contiguous allocation, right? So in both the cases, paging wins over fixed partitioning, okay? And as far as the disadvantage was concerned, fixed partitioning had a disadvantage of internal fragmentation, right? But that is again going to be reduced in case of paging, okay? So these three are major points. You can just remember. Fine. Now let us look at the example. This kind of examples are asked in GATE, right? You might be asked how many pages are there given the page size and a memory capacity, right? You might be asked that what is the number of bytes required for page number, right? You will be given five options, and from that you have to select, right? So this kind of questions are very frequent. You can easily score 2 marks for this, right? Okay. Suppose your memory supports 16-bit addresses. 16-bit addresses. So that is 2 raised to 16, right? So total available memory will be what? 64 KB, right? Now you should remember a basic concept over here. That is, whenever you are talking about K, that is always 2 raised to 10, right? Whenever you are talking about M, that is always 2 raised to 20, right? And whenever you are talking about the giga, right, it is 2 raised to 30. I have not seen a question beyond this, right? Up to giga, the questions are generally asked, right? So are you clear with the basics, right? You should just remember these three things. Okay, so let us continue. 64K, right? So it is 2 raised to 6 into 2 raised to 10. Can I say that? 2 raised to 6 into 2 raised to 10. Fine, because 2 raised to 10 is for this K, right? And remaining is for the 64. That is how you need to divide this address. Okay, so you will be usually given two things: size of memory and size of page, right? We are also given size of page over here. It is 1024 bytes or 1K, that is 2 raised to 10. So if I am dividing 2 raised to 16 available addresses into size of 2 raised to 10, right? The question is, what that will give me, that equation, that division? Yes, number of pages, right? Because you imagine an array available. That array I am dividing in parts of 2 raised to 10. Okay, so how many such parts are there? It depends upon this division, right? So 2 raised to 16, that is the total available space. If I divide that into the pages, each of the size of the pages 2 raised to 10, that is going to give you 2 raised to 6. That means how many pages I'll have? 64 pages of 1K each. Is this clear? It's very simple, right? You just have to apply simple division, right? And you will get 2 marks very quickly, right? So it is a scoring area in GATE. Fine. Paging is a very simple thing. You can easily answer the questions. Okay. What is the address structure? Now, as you know, that you are having 64 pages, right? So how many bits are required to represent that? 2 raised to 6, right? Generally, the address is in 2 raised to something, right? So 6 bits are required to represent each page number, yes or no? 6 bits are required to represent the page number, okay? So once I know that how many bits are required for page number, remaining bits will be for the offset. Remaining bits will be for the offset. And you can again verify that, right? Over here, the offset is 10 bit because it is 16 minus 6. Okay, that is our equation, fine? So how we can prove that this is a correct answer? Because each page is of 1K and 1K requires 10 bits. Yes or no? Right? So you can again cross check your answers, right? And you can make sure that you have scored 2 marks. Okay, so this is one of the options. So again, I repeat, what you might be given is, you might be given that the memory supports 16-bit address, right? So if it is just given, based on that, you can find out what is the total address space, yes or no? Because generally we assume that address is in terms of 2 raised to something. So 2 raised to 16, that is going to be what? Your available address space, right? So if even if address space size is not given, you can easily calculate, right? Based on just this line, okay? Another thing that you will be given is this, right? Page size, okay? If you are just given this, what is the length of the address and what is the size of the page? What are the entities we can find? First entity we can find is what? Number of pages, right? I need to divide the total address space by the size of the page, okay? What else we can find? How many bits are required for the page number? How many bits are required for the offset, Are you clear with this? Yes. And again, if you sum it up, 10 plus 6, you will be getting the same answer. Okay, 16 bit. It's very simple. Fine. Let us solve some very small examples. Okay, that's fine, Urjit. Yes, logical address is 31 bits. Okay. So 31, as I said, 30 will be what? Giga. Right. So 2 raised to 1 into 2 raised to 30. Right. So what is your total address space containing? 2 raised to 31. 2 raised to 31 bits. That is 2 gigabytes. Is that clear? With the first one, right? Now the address space is given and we need to find out logical address space, right? Or logical address length. Okay, so address space is given as 128M. So simply replace M with 2 raised to 20, right? Plus 2 raised to 7. So if you sum it up, the address length is what? 27 bits. Is that fine? Right? The question can be asked in either of the way, right? It is both sides of coin. Okay. Similarly, now if you forget about the paging, let us say if you forget about the pages, if you talk about frames, right? So in that case, you are given the physical address. That is, the length of the physical address is 22 bits. Okay. So 22, that means 2 plus 20. Right. So what will be that? 2 raised to 2 into 2 raised to 20. Okay. That is 4 MB. Right. Very simple. Fine. Last one. Given the address space, find out how much physical memory you are having. Okay. Given the address space. So 16 MB is given. Replace M with 20 and 16 can be represented with 2 raised to 4. Okay. So that will be 4 plus 20, 24 bit address. Is that fine? You might have solved this kind of small examples in CSA, right? But we are trying to address this with respect to OS. Fine. Okay. So you can find a lot more examples, right? If you will just look for the gate questions on paging, number of questions you will find, right? Try to solve them. Okay. They will be very easy. If you remember the basic things, 1K is equal to 10, 1M is equal to 20, and 1G is equal to 30. Okay. That's the simplest thing to remember. Okay. Let us try to take an exercise. If you are given the physical address of 12 bits, right? Frame size is 1K. So what will be the number of pages? Frames, not pages. 2 raised to 12 divided by 2 raised to 10. The answer is 2 raised to 2, that is 4. 4 frames. Yes, 4 frames. Okay. If you are given the logical address of 13 bits and page size, okay, of 1K. So 2 raised to 13, that is your total address space, divide that by 2 raised to 10. What is going to be the answer? 2 raised to 3. Okay. And what that represents? Number of pages. Number of pages. Each having 1 kilo size. Okay. Structure of physical address will be what? Let us answer this question first. Structure of physical address. How many frames we are having? Yes. How many frames we are having? 4 frames, right? So what will be the structure of physical address? How many bits for frame number? 4 bits, right? 4 bits for the four bits or 2 bits? It will be 2 bits, yes, right? Because see, we can again map out. We require 10 bits for page for offset, right? So whatever is the remaining, that is nothing but required bits for page. Okay, so 2 plus 10. Is that fine to all? Right? Okay, similarly, what will be the structure of logical address? Physical address and logical address structure will be same? Yes or no? For physical address, it will be 3 plus 10. For logical, it is 2 plus 10, right? Because logical address contains what? Pages. I think we have answered that in reverse way. Okay? Yes or no? Physical address is frame number plus offset. How many bits are required for frame number? how many bits are required for frame number? 3 bits, because how many frames we have? How many frames we have? 2 raised to 3, total 8 frames. Right, try to think logically, fine. So 3 plus 10 will be the structure of which address? I'm just asking this once again. 3 plus 10 will be a structure of which address? Physical or logical? Physical, right? Because wherever I'm saying frame, it is a physical address. We are dividing the memory into frames. We are dividing the process into pages. Just don't mix this up. Otherwise, you will lose your marks. Okay, make sure that you are reading the question correctly. Okay, if you are asked what is logical address, what is your goal? If you are asked logical address, what is your goal? Focus on pages, right? If you are asked what is physical address, what is your focus? Frames. Okay. Okay, from physical we get frame, from logical you get page. That's correct, Sainish. Right? And we again assume throughout that page size is equal to the frame size. So there won't be any confusion further, right? Yes, how 8 frames? I'll again repeat that. Okay. So I think we have misunderstood the question over here. It is physical address is 12 bits. Yes. I got it. Physical address is 12 bits, right? So the structure of physical address will be 2 plus 10. Yes, my mistake, right? 2 plus 10. That's correct. Yes, agree with you. Right? Okay. So I'm just writing the correct answer so that I can solve the confusion which is created. Right? 2 plus 10 is for physical address. Am I saying that correct now? Priyank, yes. Yes? Okay. Yes. And the remaining, that is 3 plus 10, will be for logical address. Okay, sorry, my mistake. Right? Okay. So this is how the questions can be asked, right? Either you will be asked to find both the things, structure of logical address and physical address, right? Or you will be asked to find only one thing. Okay, depends upon the complexity and marks that you will be asked for. Okay, so I hope it is easy to find. Yes or no? Okay, so as I said, try to solve more examples. Yes, frames for physical address. That's correct, Harsh. And pages for logical address, right? I hope this confusion is sorted out. Physical is greater than logical. That depends, Yash, because that depends upon how much memory we are having, right? So it is not fixed. We cannot say in general, fine. There is no definite answer to this. How they decide the page size for any hardware? Yes, page size is generally decided based on the looking at the past behavior of similar processes, right? We have to do some kind of mapping to the history. We need to see that if there was a process of this category, what was the size, right? And based on that, we can predict how many pages will require. And then we can define what will be the size of the page, right? So we need to rely on some study. And that is why OS is a subject based on research. Fine, many topics are being researched in this category. Fine, okay. Now, one more point, just to let you know, we already know this in advance, right? Just to revise. If we assume that page size and frame size are power of 2, page size and frame size are power of 2, which we know, right? Then we can prove that relative address and logical address are same, right? The figure proves this. Let us focus over here. If you assume that your relative address is this, 1502, you can see the binary representation written over here, right? If I go with paging scheme, right? And if I divide this address in two parts, that is first, let us say 6 bits are for the page number and remaining bits are for the offset, Okay, so then what I'll get? First 6 bits are representing what? 5 zeros and 1s. That means it is page number 1. And in page number 1, which byte I'm looking for, or which offset I'm looking for? The remaining bits decimal will be what? Suppose you are having this 0, 1, 1, 0, 4 1s and 0, this address, right? If you try to find the decimal representation, it will be 478. Okay, so even if you know the starting address and you are looking at a address 1502, right? And whatever you are pointing, that is this location, right? It is going to be the same as if we use paging, right? Why this is true? Because we assume that page size and frame size are of power of 2. Because ultimately you have to convert that address into what? If it is decimal address, 1502, you have to convert that into binary. And binary is always in form of 2 raised to something. Okay. So if we go with this assumption, which every OS goes with, right? If you are trying to go with relative addressing, then also you will be fine. Okay. But still, what is better? Tell me. Should we directly map to an address using the relative addressing scheme? Or should we go with paging? Which one gives you better option? Paging. That is the answer. What is the reason for that? Because we have the data structures to manage the paging, right? As well as if you go with this kind of mechanism, you will have less amount of internal segmentation. You can see that over here, isn't it? See. This last page, right? While over here, we have not shown the remaining space, but actually that is going to be wastage, right? It is faster as well because we can use indexing. That's correct, yes, right? We can use indexing, so it will be faster. But still, we should know the relativity. That is, if I go with relative address, if I'm pointing to a certain byte, and if I'm using logical address with paging, if I'm pointing to a certain byte, the target location will be same. Yes or no? Target location will be same. Okay, that's what this slide covers. Okay, so just a sideline point. You can just remember in theory that if you are using addresses of power of 2, then logical and relative addresses will be mapping to the same memory location. Okay, that is the summary. Okay, why internal segmentation is at the end? Sure. See, Sainish, because over here, you are allocating the complete page and complete frame. I am going to load the complete page into the complete frame. Yes or no? As the page size and frame size are equal, right? So I am loading my first page over here. I am going to load my second page over here, right? In this area, this portion. Okay. So now, whatever is the remaining space, right? That I have to load in the third frame. Agreed? Whatever is the remaining page, that I have to load in the third frame, right? But assume that your page size is of 2 KB, but last page is just containing 1 KB of data. Last page is containing just 1 KB of data. So can I say that remaining 1 KB will be internal segmentation? Agreed? So that is how we get only internal segmentation in the last page, right? Only in the last page, right? Okay. So this is about paging. Okay. Now let us see how translation occurs, right? Ultimately, we have to convert from which format to which format? Page number offset to frame number offset, right? So how that occurs? Let us look at the process or the algorithm, fine? If we assume that address is of having n plus m bits, where n bits are used for the page number, that is the standard convention. If you are having this question in any of the examinations, right, always the left hand side bits will be for page number, right hand side will be for the offset. So even if you are not given description, you need to assume, okay, it is always from left to right, fine. So how we need to map out, what we need to look for first, n bits or m bits? We first have to look for n bits, right? Because I want to find out the page number first, okay? So first thing is extract the page number as the leftmost n bits, right? Then use the page number as an index. Now, where we need to map that page number? In the page table, because which data structure contains the frame details? Which data structure contains the page frame details? It is the page table, okay? So I need to use the page number as an index into the page table. Let me just go back to the example which we saw earlier, just to quickly let you know, right? This is the data structure, right? Okay, I'll use this 0, 1, 2, 3 as an index, right? To find out what? 7, 8, 9, 10. What is 7, 8, 9, 10? They are frame numbers, right? Clear? Okay. Once I know that my page number 1 is lying in frame number 8, what do I need to do next? If I know that my page number 1 is lying into frame number 8, what you do next? Yes. You have reached the page. Now you need to reach the actual data. How to do that? Using offset. That's correct, right? So that is the next step. So first we find the frame number. Let us say it is K, okay? And then we generate the physical address by appending frame number with the offset. Whatever is the result, that is going to be your physical address, okay? You can see that mapping over here. For a 16-bit address, we have 6 bits for page number, 10 bits offset. Suppose this 6-bit page number maps like this, right? So 000110, which is that frame? Frame number 6, right? Frame number 6. So inside frame number 6, right? That is this part, okay? What is the actual address where we are pointing to? That is this one, right? This much part. Clear with this mapping, right? So we have to go through one level of navigation. That is correct. First, I need to find out the page table entry, right? And from the page table entry, I can locate the frame number, and that is how I need to generate the address, right? But still, this is efficient system, right? Because we are having less amount of wastage. Okay. Now, if you think about programmer's perspective, right? Generally, the program is written in terms of modules, right? Ideally, the program is written in terms of modules. So in that sense, if you think about segmentation, that might be a better approach, isn't it? Because generally your programs are divided into modules. And if I give one module to one segment, will that be better in terms of memory allocation? Instead of dividing that program into pages, what I'm doing is, if I'm having three modules, I'll go with three segments of memory. Although they might not be contiguous, but still, for object-oriented programming kind of applications, right, this will be a better approach. Okay, so that is the idea behind segmentation. Let us look at that. Yes. We'll see that. We'll see that. Yes. For process page table, in case of example, you are asking? Okay. Yes. In exam, you will not be given the page tables. Right? Generally, page table based examples are not asked, right? Yes? Okay, okay. You are asking about this structure or then this slide? After 70, okay. This one?
Yes.
Yes, what is the question? Okay, okay, okay. So, yes, she has a question that you will be given this data or not. I think that is correct, right? So, yes, this kind of examples won't be asked. Don't worry. Fine. You will not be asked to convert the logical address to physical address. Yes, you might be asked to find out the length of physical address given the frame number, given the size of the frame and total address, right? So, as I said, the example will be like this, what you can see in this slide, okay? There are it is not possible to set the equation based on this, right? Fine. So don't worry. This is just for an example how mapping occurs, right? Because this is done by CPU hardware. We are not going to do this, right? So there is no point in asking the question like this, right? Is this clear to all, right? You won't be asked the question to map out the address, okay? Fine. Okay, so we'll see the summary at the end. Before that, let us start with the segmentation. In the end, I'm going to compare paging with segmentation, okay? Fine. So if you assume that user program is divided into segments, as I said, you are writing your program in modules, right? So instead of going into pages, you divide that into segments, okay? Now, what is the property of segment? Segments can be of variable length, yes or no? Because the size of your modules will be different, agreed? Size of your modules will be different. And that is why the size of the segments will be variable. So with which method we can compare this segmentation concept? We can compare this concept with dynamic partitioning, isn't it? Yes or no? Because in dynamic partitioning, what was the assumption? The size of the partition is not fixed. It depends upon how much space is required. At runtime, we decide, right? Same way over here. Depending upon size of your module, you allocate the segment size, okay? So every segment may be of variable length, but to keep track, what is required? If we assume that there is infinite space available, is that correct to assume? No, right? So what we have to define at least? Look at your past behavior and see that
am I audible to you? Yes, there is a power failure right now. So I'm just sharing the slide once again. Please wait for just a minute. Okay, can you see my screen? Okay, thank you.
On my way.
For time being, I'll continue with the phone so that we don't lose the important part of this. Okay, so we were at this slide, right? Can you all, are you all with me? Segmentation, right? Okay, fine. So I cannot see your responses right now. I'm assuming that
yes, sir, visible.
You all are with me, right? Fine. The question. Okay, fine. Thank you. Thank you. So you may speak in between, right? If there's any issue or inquiry, right? So segments are variable in length. Plus, we need to define the maximum segment length, right? Because if you don't know what is the maximum capacity, then you will not be able to perform the allocation, right? So, listening, right? Okay, clear up to this.
Yes,
now,
sir.
In previous case, we were having the address structure was page number and offset. Right? While in this case, what will be the only difference? Instead of page number, we'll have segment number. Again, there will be an offset, right? Because in segment, which byte you are looking for, right? That is what is required. Okay. So, to keep track of this allocation, we require again data structure. In paging, we were using page table. Okay. And how many page tables are allocated per process or per system? What was the concept? One page table per process, right? Similarly, over here, we have one segment table per process, right? One segment table per process. And what that segment table entry will contain? If you remember, what each page table entry was containing? Just one entry, that is frame number, right? Number of the frame that we are having. While in this case, what you will require? You not only require the segment, but you require the starting address of the segment plus the length of the segment. Because see, first you should know which is the segment you are looking for, which is the segment you are looking for. And the second thing is how many bytes that segment is containing, right? Why we are keeping this entry? So that we don't go beyond that address when we are actually traversing that segment. We'll see that mapping right in the slide. Okay, let me join from the computer now. Power is back so that we can continue in a better approach and better way. Till that, you go through. So first, we extract the segment number. Okay, then we use this segment number as an index in the process. We use the segment number as an index in the process segment table. Okay, to find the physical. So first, we find out which segment is containing my data. First, we find out which segment is containing my number. Now, we compare the offset with the length. We compare the offset with the length. What does that mean? Why it is required? Yes, you can see this diagram. This will make you more clear. Just give me a minute. I'm sharing my screen once again so that you can have. So I'm joining back from the
Okay, can you hear me once again clearly? Yes, okay, thank you. Sorry for the interruption. There was a power failure for around 10 minutes, so we had missed that part. Let me again go back to the slides. Okay, so I'll just share this slide once again. Okay, so let us now focus on the example directly so that you can understand the theory part, right? First part is we have to find out the segment number. Okay, you will get the segment number from where? You will get the segment number from where? From the address, isn't it? From the address itself, okay? Based on the segment number, I will be using the segment number as an index. So it is 0001. That means it is pointing to segment number 1, yes or no? It is pointing to segment number 1, okay? Is that fine up to this translation process? Okay, fine. Next, what we need to find? What is the length of the segment? Right, this is your segment table. This is your segment table. From there, I am finding the length of my segment. Okay, now this segment length is available. Plus, I am also given the starting address. Okay, so why we are storing the length over here? Can you tell me? What is the point in maintaining the length of the segment? So that when the actual address is generated, we can verify that that actual address is within the boundary. Yes, exactly, because of dynamic length. That's correct, Priyank. Absolutely pinpoint answer, right? So that's what we need to do. Use the segment number as an index into the segment table to find the starting physical address, right? We compare the offset. We compare the offset with the length, okay? If offset is greater than the length, what we can say? Address is invalid. Agree? If your offset is greater than length, that means you are trying to go beyond your current segment, right? And that is where which kind of error gets generated? You have seen that many times in earlier OS labs. Segmentation fault, right? Why we were getting segmentation fault? Because we were pointing to the area which was beyond our reach, right? Or it was not allocated. There are two options. Okay, fine. So that is the concept over here. We have to compare the offset, that is this remaining bytes, right, with the, you can say, length. Okay, if the offset is greater than length, address is invalid. Otherwise, we are within bounds. Are you clear up to this third point? Right? If you are within bounds, what we can do? Generate the physical address. Now, how we can generate a physical address? Append base with offset. That is going to give you the current address. Clear? Right? With segmentation. So tell me, what is the benefit of segmentation over paging? If you are asked this question, what will be your answer? Or they are not comparable strategies. That can also be an answer, right? Variable size. Correct. Correct. That is one valid point, right? Size of the segments are not fixed. Internal fragmentation can be reduced. Okay. So in that case, Priyank, we are going to have internal fragmentation or we are going to have external fragmentation in case of segmentation. We have external. Right, because it is comparable to the dynamic partitioning technique. So remember, fixed partitioning and paging, both are having same problem, which is that fixed partitioning and paging, both are having internal fragmentation. Similarly, variable partitioning, or you can say dynamic partitioning, and segmentation, both are having external fragmentation. But the amount of fragmentation is definitely reduced in case of either paging or segmentation. Okay. And more of this is better for which kind of programs? Where you are writing modular structure in your code, right? Where you are writing modular structure. So for newer programming languages, segmentation might be better, right? But again, what is the issue over here? The size can be very large, right? So you will require that much memory to be allocated. What if that much memory is not available in main memory space? You can't allocate that process, isn't it? I hope you are getting my point, right? If the size of your process is very huge, right, then segmentation might be difficult to achieve, but paging might still work, right? Okay. We can't have external fragmentation in dynamic or segmentation. Okay. You will have internal fragmentation. No, internally is not possible, right, in case of dynamic partitioning. Why? Because you are allocating the entire, okay, I'll take you back to that slide so that you can just recall. Instead of explaining, that will save our time. Yes. So this white spaces are unallocated spaces, right? While gray spaces are allocated spaces, right? So what can we say about this white space? It is outside any partition. It is outside any partition. That's why it is known as external fragmentation, right? Are you getting this, Sainish? So internal is not possible. Okay, in main memory, can paging? Yes, yes. Actually, that is going to be covered as a separate topic. If you want to overcome the disadvantages of both, or if you want to combine advantages of both, then what we can do? Yes, what will be the interesting concept if you combine both the things together? Paging with segmentation. That is being used in many OSs at present, right? Because it combines both the approaches. So we'll be covering that in the virtual memory chapter. Once we cover the virtual memory concept, is that fine, Dev? So that is coming up, right? Yes. But for that, I require to explain you the virtual memory concepts, right? So please wait till that. Okay. Now I'll just summarize this lecture by just a simple comparison table, right? Okay, so if you go with fixed partitioning, what is the concept? We divide the main memory into static partitions at which time? System generation time, right? So when your system starts, at that point itself, you need to decide what is the size of your partition, okay? What about placement algorithm? We can load our process anywhere, isn't it? It is not fixed, right? We can load our process anywhere, wherever the partition is available, okay? What is the strength? It is very simple, because we decide everything at early time, right? We are not leaving anything at runtime, okay? Little OS overhead. Why? Because you are not supposed to keep track over here. Wherever you are supposed to keep track, overhead is high, right? Generally. What is the disadvantage? Internal fragmentation and number of processes to be in main memory are limited. Number of processes to be in main memory are limited. Are you clear with this first row? Fixed partitioning, right? If you go in reverse, opposite, right? If you take the opposite of that, what will be that? Dynamic partitioning, right? In dynamic partitioning, there is no internal fragmentation, right? And we can say that we are using efficiently in a better approach. But what about overhead? Overhead is higher. Why? Because we have to search, right? We have to search for available space, and then we need to perform allocation, right? What is the disadvantage? External fragmentation, but we can solve external fragmentation, right? By which technique? Compaction, right? So what is the actual disadvantage? Cost of compaction, right? that is very high. Okay. Simple paging, we have just seen that we divide the main memory into number of equal size frames and we divide the process into number of fixed size pages. Okay. Process is loaded anywhere, wherever the free frame is available. Okay, it is not fixed. Advantage, no external fragmentation. Agreed? Right? In case of paging, there is no external fragmentation. But we have small amount of internal fragmentation. Where? In the last page only. Okay? Simple segmentation. We divide the process into segments. Okay? A process will be loaded, right? With all its segment. Remember, this all is important. Over here, we are assuming that virtual memory is not applicable. That is why if you want to execute a process, it has to be loaded completely. All or none. That kind of behavior we have in absence of virtual memory. But if you have virtual memory, you can load a process partially. Right? That is the advantage. Right? We are going to start with virtual memory from next class. Right? So we will be clear with that. Fine. What is the strength? Same like fixed partitioning. Dynamic partitioning. No internal fragmentation, right? But still we have external fragmentation. So this chart you can remember, right? This is actually a summary of entire chapter, right? So chapter number 7 is over, right? Now we'll start with chapter 8, virtual memory, from next class. Okay. Thank you for maintaining the repo. Even the power was failed. We'll continue, right, from next class.